Today we'll start with the plants containing lectins are tox albumin, and the picture of which is Abrus precatorius plant gulganjigida anta.
So the second phytotoxin that we are going to discuss today is the plants containing the lectins are tox albumins. So we get two plants which contain lectins and tox albumin. The first one is Abrus precatorius and the second one is the castor bean plant. So the first plant, Abrus precatorius, we call it as the Rajkumar of our toxicology. So why we call it as Rajkumar of our toxicology is, see, the great actor Rajkumar is called by different name. So he is called as Natasarvabhoma, Kannada Kantirava, Karnataka Ratna. So likewise, Abrus precatorius, it is also called by Rosary pea, Rati, Jequirity bean, Rosary pea, or Sui poisoning or Sutari poisoning. So why the name Sui poisoning is, so in Hindi, so the thread and needle we call it as Sui Daga. So what the people used to do is, so they used to lace the needle with this Abrus precatorius toxin and they used to inject to the cattle. So with the intention to take out the leather from the cattle, so they used to intentionally kill the cattle. So that's how it got the name Sui poisoning, nothing to do with the suicidal poisoning. Suicidal poisoning, it is not the same as Sui poisoning. Sui poisoning, it is mainly due to the Abrus precatorius plant. So the unique feature of Abrus precatorius is it contain black and red seeds. So in Kannada we call it as Gulaganji Bija. So you might have seen these seeds also. So unique black and red seed, very much similar to the ladybug. See, ladybug, Jirunde, it's an insect. So with black and red color. So although ladybug is harmless, whereas our Abrus precatorius seeds are very harmful. So it is trailing and twinning vine. So baldi idu. So only crushed seeds are poisonous. See, the whole seed as such, it is not poison. So if we ingest the whole seeds of Abrus precatorius, or if you give whole seed of the Abrus to any animal, so it will not kill an animal. So only the crushed seed or broken seed will produce the toxicity. So crushed seeds, they are very commonly used in intentional poisoning or malicious poisoning. So as I told, the cattle leather, so to get the cattle leather, they used to poison the cattle. And also in human beings also, intentional poisoning is done with the broken or crushed seeds of Abrus precatorius. So which is the major phytotoxin present in Abrus precatorius plant? It is called as abrin. So there are other minor phytotoxins. They are abrine, abrolin, hemagglutinin. So whole seeds, they are not toxic, only broken or crushed forms are more toxic. And this Abrus precatorius seeds, very commonly they are used as jewelry, so or beads. Since it is colorful, it is very commonly used or wear as jewelry by the woman. So whether it causes toxicity, see, if a woman is wearing jewelry, accidentally the beads have fallen down. So if it is eaten by a sheep or cattle, whether it will suffer from toxicity? Yes, definitely it will suffer from toxicity. Why? The beads, see, yen martivi navu aa beads na ponsodike, we broke a certain part of the seed, so it might cause toxicity if it is ingested by an animal. So susceptible animals are humans, and horses are more susceptible than cattle and sheep. So abrin is a phytotoxin of Abrus precatorius. Ricin is a phytotoxin of castor bean. So both are lectins. So which is more toxic? So when you compare two lectins, abrin is more toxic than the ricin. And abrin, it is extremely toxic. What do you mean by extremely toxic? Less than 1 milligram per kg body weight. The LD50 value is enough to kill 50% of the animals. So abrin toxin, it is very much similar to the viper snake venom. So such will be the toxicity of this abrin. What is the mechanism of action of abrin? See, abrin, it has got two chains, chain A and chain B. Chain B, so what it will do, it will bind with the host cell membrane and it will help in the internalization of the chain A. So once chain A gets inside, it will inhibit the protein synthesis by inactivating which subunit of ribosome? It will inactivate 26 subunit of the ribosome. So in nutshell, what abrin will do? Abrin will inhibit the protein synthesis. So for all this process, it will take time. So it has to inhibit the, it has to inactivate the ribosome, then it should in turn inhibit the protein synthesis. So whole process takes time. So the onset of action in abrin toxicity, it will be slow. So there will be slow onset of action. And the second mechanism of action is, it damages the lining of the gastrointestinal tract and also damages liver and kidney. So that's why hepatitis and nephritis will be there in abrin toxicity as well. So clinical signs, generally late onset of action because of aforesaid reason. So 1 day or 2 days after eating Abras precatorius, the clinical signs starts appearing. So the clinical signs are nausea, vomition, GIT irritation, abdominal pain, diarrhea, ruminal atony, anorexia and muscle twitching. So muscle twitching, later on there will be incoordination, dyspnea, convulsions, coma, and if untreated, there will be death of the animal. So the second plant which contain the lectins or toxalbumin is castor bean or the Ricinus communis. So in Kannada we call it as arul bija. So arulinena we extract from this arul bija. So castor oil we will extract from this castor bean. So where we use this castor bean, very commonly used as a protein source in the form of castor cake. See, arulindi anta kodthivi animals castor cakes. See, when it is toxic, see arulindi na generally cattle kodthivi yavaga toxicity agutte arulindi tinnodrinda, if it is untreated. See, after extracting oil from the castor bean, so they will make castor cake. So before doing this castor care, before giving castor cake to the animal, it will be eaten. So it will be pre-treated or it will be eaten to certain temperature. After that, we have to give this castor cake. If the castor cake is untreated, as such, if castor cake without any pre-treatment, if it is given to the animal, definitely it will cause castor bean toxicity. So which parts of plant are toxic? Leaves are also toxic. Crushed seeds are also toxic. Untreated castor cakes are toxic. So what are the phytotoxins present? The major phytotoxins are ricin 1 and ricin 2. So among 1 and 2, ricin 2 is more toxic than the ricin 1. Important one. So ricin 2 is more toxic than ricin 1. So this ricin, the phytotoxin, it resembles bacterial exotoxin. So it can be hyper immunized for it. So bacterial exotoxin, the feature of a bacterial exotoxin is you can hyper immunize against the bacterial exotoxin. Similarly, you can prepare a hyper immune serum against the ricin toxin. So abrin, it resembles viper snake venom, whereas ricin resembles bacterial exotoxin. So here whole seeds are not toxic, only if it is crushed or broken it will be toxic. Susceptibility wise, horses more susceptible than dogs, more susceptible than cattle, more susceptible than sheep. So generally poultry, they are resistant. Then mechanism of action. So similar to abrin, ricin 2 also contain chain A and B. So the mechanism of action also similar to abrin. Chain B, it binds to the host cell membrane, helps in the internalization of the chain A. And this chain A, it's going to inactivate the ribosome. So which subunit of ribosome is inhibited here? It inhibits 60S subunit of ribosome, whereas abrin inhibits 26S subunit of the ribosome. Then clinical signs, since they are lectins, toxalbumin, obviously the clinical signs are similar to abrin. Postmortem findings same, diagnosis similar. Treatment, so symptomatic treatment only. Apart from that, you can give hyper immune serum against this ricin toxicity, since it resembles bacterial exotoxin. So what are the postmortem findings in both abrin and ricin toxicity? So non-specific postmortem finding, you might find GIT ulcerations, there will be necrosis of liver and kidney, generalized petechia all over the body. Then diagnosis, see the very important diagnostic feature in both castor bean and abrin toxicity are the identification of the source. If you don't identify the source, very difficult to diagnose the toxicity condition. Then the other features of diagnosis, you have to depend on other feature of the diagnosis. Then treatment, no specific therapy, only general line of treatment. So MS is lavage, you can give activated charcoal, then fluid and electrolyte therapy. In resin, you can go for hyperimmune serum administration also. So this is about the plants containing toxalbumin or lectin. So there was some assignment question. See, resin resembles dash toxin, abrin resembles dash toxin. So subunit of the ribosomes inactivated by abrin and resin respectively. So group of toxin from castor bean and rosary pea are called as dash. Sui poisoning is produced by dash, which is more toxic, resin or abrin. So please complete it and submit it, okay? So photos showing the Abrus precatorius plant, the photos showing Ricinus communis plant, it will be displayed as soon as this video is completed. So please watch that also.
See the seed? So it is just like a ladybug, red and black color. So this is also the twinning plant. So abrin seeds used as a jewelry. See, this Buddhist monk, they used to wear this jewelry rather than a woman. See some of the abrin effects. See the needle, you can see in the right corner, the needle they used to implant it to the cattle also. So they used to kill a person also. See, the it is very much similar to viper snake venom. When you use that needle and if you eat it to a person, so these are the symptoms they will show. So what are the instances of poisoning? So generally they will keep needle between the finger and they will put it on the cattle, or they will slap it on a people. So intentional poisoning. So this is a Ricinus communis plant. So arul bijad gidaido. So now
plants containing lectin or toxalbumin is completed.